Before we begin this tutorial, Shop Floor Automations reminds users to please power off their machines completely before repeating any steps of this process. Please be sure to also follow lockout tagout procedures and other OSHA standards. Thank you. First, open the control panel and remove the power cord. Remove the ribbon cable, which is connected to the motherboard. Using a small screwdriver, remove the screws. Once the ribbon cable and power cable are unplugged, remove the nuts that are holding in the drive. You will need a socket wrench in order to do this. Once you have removed the screws and nuts, carefully remove the core from the housing of the cabinet. Save all the screws and components as you'll need them in order to reinstall. Slide your core unit received from Shop Floor Automations into the original spot. Be sure to clear all cables as you slide the hardware back in. Reattach the nuts that you removed from the housing in order to hold the unit in place. Be sure that everything is mounted properly in the orientation shown. Then, reattach the power cable and ribbon cable. It is ideal that you first attach the ribbon cable before powering on the unit. Soon, the operator will be up and running and will be able to use USB sticks instead of floppy disks. Please refer to your setup guide for additional instructions or call Shop Floor Automations for further assistance. Thanks for watching!